promising texture filter could capture carbon dioxide from air. Global temperatures are steadily rising and we are getting close to the point of no return, a permanent increase of 2 degrees Celsius. One way to fight is to contain carbon dioxide in the air to cut down greenhouse gases in the atmosphere. New research showed that a textile-based filter can do that. There's a good chance that we cannot stop the permanent 2 degrees Celsius increase in global temperatures. Decades of polluting the atmosphere resulted in this likely irreversible increase in global temperatures. If we only contained the greenhouse gases better, millions wouldn't have to suffer the consequences. Although too late in the upcoming temperature shift, we still can do a lot to prevent the next one. At North Carolina State University, researchers discovered that they could filter CO2 from air and gas mixtures at promising rates using a new textile-based filter. It combines fabric and an enzyme called carbonic anhydrase. With this technology, we want to stop carbon dioxide emissions at the source, and power plants are the main source of carbon dioxide emissions right now, said lead author Jialong Shen. The real deal in their design is the enzyme carbonic anhydrase, a naturally occurring enzyme that hastens a reaction where CO2 and water turn into a compound of baking soda called bicarbonate. Our bodies also have carbon anhydrase, which is used to assist the transport of CO2 out of the lungs. To make the filter, the team attached the enzyme to two-layer cotton fabric by soaking it in a solution with chitosan. This material physically traps the enzyme so it sticks to the fabric. Once the filter is ready, they conducted experiments to test how good it is in filtering CO2 and nitrogen, common emissions from power plants. Published in ACS Sustainable Chemistry and Engineering, the fabric was rolled in a spiral and shoved into a tube. The gas was pushed through the tube, along with a water-based solution. Then, CO2 reacted with water in the solution and the enzyme. Bicarbonate was formed and dripped down the filter in the tube. Researchers then captured the compound from the tube. The performance rate was for 4 liters per minute of air. It could extract 52.3% of CO2 with a single-stack filter and 81.7% with a double-stack filter. To compare, a full-scale operation for commercial power plants will demand the processing of over 10 million liters of flue gas per minute. So, researchers are now working with collaborators to test their design on a bigger scale. Besides performance, the enzyme is durable, and the filter still works even after 5 cycles of washing, drying, and sorting. What's your take on this carbon-capturing filter? Will it work on existing power plants? Share thoughts in the comment section. Till our next video, thanks for watching.